back, we will visibly see Jesus come back. And you'll notice a point there. This is an interesting point. Notice this point. In Acts chapter 1 there, it told us a cloud, as Christ went up, a cloud received him out of their sight. Now notice this verse here in Revelation chapter 1 verse 7, talking about the second coming of Christ. It says, "Behold, he cometh with clouds," there's those clouds again, "and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all the kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him." So here we find, talking about the second coming of Christ now, the Bible's telling us that he's going to come back, what? With clouds. A cloud received him out of their sight. Now he's coming back with clouds, and every eye will see him. Of course, the question is, how many eyes is every eye? Every eye, friend, is simply every eye will see Jesus Christ return. And he's also coming back with the clouds. Notice how it's told in Matthew 24, verse 30. Jesus himself said these words. He said, "And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall," what? "See the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory." So here we find the exact same scenario. Exactly as Jesus went up into the heavens is exactly how he will come back. Every eye will see him. It'll be with the clouds. And you'll notice there the sad story is, the Bible tells us that the tribes of the earth are mourning. Why are the tribes of the earth mourning when Jesus comes back? Simply, friends, they're mourning simply because they are not ready for the second coming of Christ. They have put off that day of preparation and they are unprepared when Jesus comes back. But you and I, friends, have the opportunity now to prepare, to study his word, to find salvation in our lives and find Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior in our hearts. And that brings us to our third point. So we have a literal event, a visible event, but we're also told it will be a glorious event, a glorious event. Notice Titus chapter 2, verse 13. It says, "Looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ." It's going to be a glorious appearing. Now, we can all conjure up in our minds what we think this might be like, this glorious appearing. But what does it really mean to be a glorious appearing? How will this event be glorious? This is the question we have to ask ourselves. Notice also what the Bible says here in Matthew 25, verse 31. It says, "When the Son of Man shall come in his glory, and all the holy angels with him." So once again, another verse of Scripture referring to the second coming of Christ being glorious. The Bible says that Jesus himself is going to come in his glory. Now, we don't know really what the glory of Jesus Christ will be like. We can only speculate of what that glory will be like. But it also tells us here that all the holy angels are going to come with him. Now this starts to give us a little glimpse of the glory of the second coming of Christ. When all the holy angels come with Jesus Christ, that is going to be a sight you won't miss. Because we are told that we have guardian angels. Now, to my little mind, that means there must be at least 6 billion angels. If everybody on this earth has a guardian angel, there has to be at least 6 billion. That's a lot of angels, isn't it? The book of Daniel chapter 7, it talks about the angels. It says there are 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands. And the Bible tells us that when Jesus comes, all the holy angels will be with him. This, my friend, will be a glorious event. How much glory does one angel have? If I was to ask you, what is the glory of one angel? If you saw an angel, what would it be like? What sort of glory would that portray to you and I? Well, we find out what an angel is like from the story of the death of Christ. You see, the Bible tells us that Jesus Christ died. He was taken from the cross. He was placed in the tomb. And the Jews were concerned that someone would come and steal his body. The disciples, they thought they'll steal his body and say he was risen from the dead. So they asked Pilate, they said, "Can we have a station of soldiers placed at the tomb's entrance so no one can steal the body?" And that's what took place. But we find our story here is picked up in Matthew chapter 28, that early on Sunday morning, there's the guards at the tomb of Christ, and it's now time for Jesus Christ to be resurrected from the dead. The Bible says that an angel appears. Now notice what this angel is like. Matthew 28 verse 3. It says, "His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. Friends, this is one angel. This one angel appears to roll the tombstone of Christ away. And it says his countenance was like lightning and the raiment was white as snow. And it goes on and says, and for fear of him, the angel, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. Here we find these hardened Roman soldiers guarding the tomb of Christ. One angel comes. Tells us his countenance was like lightning. His clothing, as it were, was white as snow. And when these Roman soldiers saw this one angel, the glory of one angel, friends, they did shake and they became like dead men. Now you put that back into the context of Jesus coming with his glory and all the holy angels coming with him. This, my friends, is going to be a glorious event. This will not be an event that you will miss. When Jesus comes, the Bible says, every eye will see him. And friends, when Jesus comes, every eye will see him, and it will be a glorious event. Now, why are the angels coming with Christ? Why would the Bible say all the holy angels are coming with Christ? I believe this is my own speculation. But from my reading of the Bible, we find that the angels are tirelessly working for our salvation. They are working day in, day out to protect us, to guide us, to encourage us in the right paths of life. And when Jesus comes to take his people to be with him, I can imagine the angels begging the Lord, saying, please, can we come and welcome these people into the kingdom of heaven? Friends, right now, angels are working on our behalf. Right now, there are angels in this room as I'm speaking, impressing the hearts of those who are listening, trying to get them to take on the word of God and salvation into their life. And they want to come and meet you on that great day when Jesus Christ comes back to this world. Now, if anybody knows how Jesus is going to come, you'd think it would be Jesus himself, wouldn't you? Notice how Jesus said he would come back to the world. In Matthew 24, verse 27, Jesus said, for as the lightning cometh out of the east and shineth even unto the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Jesus said, it's like lightning. You know, friends, we've all seen that lightning before. Those lightning storms come through and it shines from the east and goes right through to the west. What Jesus Christ is saying is you won't miss the second coming of Christ. It will be seen by every eye. The glory of his second coming will be like lightning, lighting up the sky from east to west. That's how Christ will come back to this earth. And you and I have all seen that lightning before. And sometimes it can be frightening, can't it? The power of that lightning coming across the east to the west. But that's how Jesus Christ will come. With his glory, with the glory of the Father, with the glory of the angels. It will be so bright and so glorious. In fact, it will be so bright and so glorious that we are told that the brightness of the second coming of Christ actually destroys the wicked. Notice this verse here in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 8. Talking about the wicked, it says, the wicked whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. The second coming of Christ will be so glorious and be so bright that the wicked who try to hide themselves will literally be destroyed by the brightness of the second coming of Christ. And friends, I'm glad that you and I today had that opportunity to commit our lives to him, to learn about salvation, to find a shelter in Christ so that when that day comes, we will not find ourselves destroyed, but we will find ourselves having a place in God's eternal kingdom. So far we've learned that Christ's coming will be a literal event, it will be a visible event, it will be a glorious event, and we also find in point number 4, it will be an audible event. It's going to be something you can see and also hear at the same time. You know, Psalms 50 verse 3, the Bible says, our God shall come and shall not keep silence. When Jesus comes back to this earth, it's not going to be quiet and secret. He won't come back secretly and silently. He shall not keep silence. How will it not be silent? What's going to take place here that will make it an audible event? Well, Jesus himself tells us in Matthew 24, verse 31, and he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect. You see, friends, one of the reasons why the angels are going to come back with Jesus Christ to this earth is to gather the people of God, the elect, the Bible calls them. But you'll notice here in Matthew 24, verse 31, that when Jesus comes back, there's heard the great sound of a